All right, so we are here with To Speak of Wolves. They actually just finished their set not long ago, which was nuts. There were people everywhere. That's one thing. So give me some of your musical influences as far as what you try to mimic in a way.
A lot of the stuff that I grew up listening to is stuff like Tool and Nine Inch Nails, stuff that's a little bit darker. And I just try to approach playing guitar like without using like traditional guitar method. I just try to kind of like think about how the notes like work together and the voices and stuff like that. So and try to whenever I write a part that's based on another part, I try to have like sort of contrary motion to what's already going on, so it's not just two guitar parts doing the same thing the whole time. So that's my personal approach to writing guitar. It's not like a traditional guitar type of thing. I mean, we like to throw in a couple little twists, but we try not to do anything like too complicated that would bore us if we were listening to it, you know. So we do like the kind of like a traditional song structure, or maybe just what would you say since we've been
there, so. A lot of the thing we do too is really focused on like what is song as like the color of the song or something like that. So like when we write different parts, like, well, does this part really like match the color of the part before it? Do they blend well? Things like that. So like I write all the lyrics, so I'll write a couple, I think of something like in the back of the van and I put it on my phone and I'll, crawl from there, hey Aaron, what do you think of this? And be like, cool, I like that, whatever. So we'll be like, cool man, how, what's the emotion, of these lyrics or something like that, So like we kinda just like it sounds really weird, but like we do like a lot of like shapes and like colors, like, well, that's kinda like, there's a triangle or whatever, It's really weird, but it's what works for us, like things like that. But as far as like influences, I really like Aaron just got me like Nine Inch Nails like 2 weeks ago, so I really like Nine Inch Nails now. They're really cool. I love Oh Sleeper's new record, Children of Fire, and I like Shai Hulud and 100th, and I listen to a lot of country music. So I don't know if you saw me, I was wearing a Garth Brooks shirt earlier tonight. Like, I actually really like country music, so, because it's like, you hear so much heavy music, it's like, you need to take a break from that, Like, my mind will be like, my brain will be melted by the end of the night. So, we really listen to just, like, a lot of different stuff. I like My Epic a lot, and,
You're new in the band, and you're going to be going, y'all are going to be recording a new album.
Yeah.
Are y'all thinking about a concept album as far as the music goes, or not?
I don't know. We've been writing a lot of lyrics. The way like the lyrics are going right now kind of is it's like more like family like struggle type of stuff, like with families and like families breaking apart. Like a good friend of mine, like his dad killed himself, so like we wrote a song about that. We're working on a song about that right now. I don't know what else is kind of, I think it's just like a lot of like kids coming from broken homes, stuff like that. So
how exciting is it to actually get into a studio, lay down the tracks, listen to them mastered, and then just throw them out to the public and wait for to hear what they say?
It is awesome, man. It always takes way too long. You get so pumped about it from the second that they're, even before they're done, before you're done recording them. And there's so many things that go into like actually making a release as far as like communicating with the record label and whatever they have to do. And so it takes a long time. All day long, for months at a time, just like, I can't wait for you guys to hear this, you guys are going to love this, like, we're so proud of it already, or whatever, so.
Months ago, we did, like, four, like, demo tracks to, like, show the label, like, what direction the band's moving into, and it was like, oh my god, it's going to be so awesome, and it was cool, because it's my first time recording with the band, so I was, like, really excited, and so that was really cool, because they heard it and they're just like, oh man, this is sweet. Let's, put you in the studio a little bit sooner. So it was really awesome. So it's really, really cool.
The worst part about being on tour is the smell. No, I'm just kidding. It's exactly what he said. It's just a lot of times for people who have never been on tour, like your friends and family, they kind of don't understand like why you can't be there for their birthday or for, whatever special occasion or, things like that. And so it's kind of hard to just be like, I can't, this is my job. I can't leave work, especially since I'm in Louisiana or California or wherever. I can't just come home for a day, but So that's one of the hardest things. That, and even when you get home and people are like, where you been, man? You know, it's just like, dude, I'm sorry, man. I would hang out a lot more, but I've been everywhere else but here, you know.
All right, so why don't you give us a little sneak peek of what's going to come out Monday?
All right, we've got a music video coming out Monday for a song on our record called Quirkus Alba, which if you guys like Under Oath, Spencer from Under Oath is on the track, and he made an appearance in the video too. And it's a really cool video. We did more than just kind of play in it. We did a little bit of like sort of acting, you know, not with like lines or anything, obviously, but and it's kind of a yeah, there's a backstory, and it's kind of about like the world after the world has ended, the world after Armageddon or something. So, do you want to add anything?
Yeah, it's really cool. Like, you know, I won't give you all the details, but like, starts off and there's like, you know, abandoned cities, you know, holes in buildings, kind of things like that, and he gives you these different clues, you know, like what's going on, and then you know, like Spencer's like in this room, like trying to like, you know, communicate with us and trying to find us, and you know, we're like just like jamming out in this like underground like place. But that's all I'm gonna say. It comes out Monday. I don't want to give it away. It's really, really cool. And it was my first music video, so I was like super stoked about it. It's pretty cool.
All right, well, thanks for having us.
I appreciate it, man.
Check them out on Facebook, To Speak of Wolves.
Thank you so much.
We're out.
Later, y'all.